We have made it, the first grand final of the year, and it's going to be EU who gets to claim who the best is first. After that, we're going to go change gears, look at North America, and see who the number one team is from that region. But we have two fierce opponents in the EU right now to try to write their names in the sand. My name is Rich. I'm going to be joined by Zico, Supatiz, and Van Rookie. One note that I do want to make before we start analyzing what's going to happen in this series, this one is going to be a best of seven. So that's going to come into effect here, Zico. A lot of the time we talk about how the map pool diminishes. How else do you think it could come into play in this particular series?
Well, I think it's going to just limit a lot of these options that Method Black has. I don't think the map pool is going to be a big issue in terms of the Choccy Milkman, since they're just playing that one composition. But for Method Black, if the Choccy Milkman pick a small map, it's going to limit their options to pick these wizard comps that we saw in the previous matchup. We're going to see more kind of forced situations where they might have to go to something like the mirror because they are forced to play on something like Hook Point or Blade's Edge, one of those smaller, kind of less conventional maps.
Now, for anybody who's in the chat right now who's like, Milk who? Let's actually break down who this team is. It's a brand new team name and a brand new roster, Supatiz.
Alf Knobber is a legendary Restoration Druid from times long past, has made his return in quite a dominant fashion, defeating the teams that qualified to the World Finals with ease to this point, and now a second shot at Method Black. If they beat them once, but not once, but twice in a single tournament, Fnobbers is definitely a phenomenal druid and showcasing how powerful it is in the current meta as well. And he is obviously backed up by Galubaba, who competed last year and did not have a roster that could properly utilize him. Even though his team liked to blame him a lot, I don't think Galubaba was the problem on Reformed
did
overall.
They like to blame him?
I think there was a little bit of shade thrown to Gelu when they were playing their jungle and dominating everybody, and then whenever they tried to use him, they just lose. So I can only imagine there's some frustration there, especially between Flappers and him. So Gelu has obviously found a new home here, a safe new place to be, and obviously being in Fnobber's arms, I would be pretty happy.
I feel like Sid maybe
dramatized a little bit.
I feel like Sid just made up a whole bunch of shade, which we don't need to do here because we are currently living in a forest of trees. Plenty of resto druids to be going around. Let's talk about the competition in Method Black. Obviously, this is a team, if you've watched WoW before, you're already going to know.
Ooh.
This is a roster that, the only roster in EU that has stayed together, and now they will be in it.
Whoa. How does it feel to be right, first of all, Rich? Druidmere.
It feels very good. It also feels very exciting to see Method Black, a fan favorite, being doubted a little bit, seeing how much chat has come around to the Choccy Milkman.
Yeah, Choccy Milkman and Method Black feels good, man, and the Rogue Mage Druid Mirror. Raikou and Waz and Chaz are trying to showcase here that they are just as good at this composition as Choccy Milkman. Going to be interesting to see how it plays out. When we saw this matchup earlier in the tournament, it was all about the Fire Mages and going for those greater Power Blasts to really set up their team.
Chaz gets found. Waz is trying to protect him, staying right next to him. Ashley wants to open on him. Is he going to be able to save Chaz? Waz sees Ashley. He's waiting. He's going to open on the opener. Waz counter engages. Ashley and Chaz could both be in danger here. Chaz is able to trade effectively. Fnobber's actually getting swapped too by Waz as the Druids are the opening target in this match. A bit unexpected. It could be a bit of a quick finish.
Tons
of damage. Fnobbers, what are you going to do? You haven't been under this much pressure in the tournament so far as they commit everything to take him down. Will he fall? Waz goes all out. Fnobbers is not running Guardian Affinity. It's going to be very difficult for him to recover through this pressure. He needs help. Where is it? Gelu drops the Ring of Frost to support. Fnobbers somehow stays in the fight despite the all-in attempt by Method Black.
That was a beautiful peel coming in from Gelu and Ashley. In the meantime, Raikou, he's just getting low. Ironbark was committed. Fast-paced gameplay. Raikou trying to pull away as he's taking quite a bit of damage. Smoke Bomb does get dropped out by Ashley. Greater Power Blast coming in from Gelu, forcing out the Ice Block onto Raikou. Cauterize does proc as well, so they got sort of a two for one there on Raikou.
All right, Fnobbers gets out of that perfectly intact. Ashley still has Vendetta. Here's a Smoke Bomb attempt by Waz. Gets completely owned by Gelu. Double Dragon's Breath, but a Cyclone on Fnobbers is continuing the chain. Ashley has the game-winning factor here with Vendetta. He's going to commit this at any moment, but he's just so far behind on health. Fnobbers needs to recover. Ashley runs away. They see the opening to take Raikou down here with no cauterizing, no ice block. If they can set it up perfectly, Choccy Milkman should be able to take game one in this best of seven grand finals. Who's going to be the first European champion in this spring season? Well, you're going to find out at the end of this series. You don't want to go anywhere.
Gelu gets a greater power blast. Raikou gets a greater power blast. Kidney shot committed on Waz. A lot of pressure on Waz right now as he gets lower and lower. Gladiator Safeguard does proc. Bash Cyclone now onto Chaz as Waz runs for his life. Doesn't want to have to commit anything else. He really doesn't have that much left, except the evasion. Vendetta's going to be up shortly. Phenomer's almost getting his trinket back. You can see Chaz setting up Raikou. There's a full polymorph. Do they have the damage on Gelu or Ashley? There's the full kidney shot. Gelu trying to play Peeler right now, looking for the polymorph. Finds it on Raikou. Ashley should be able to survive as Phenomer's is out of crowd control. Very nicely done by Gelu. Gets the polymorph on Raikou, interrupts Chaz. Complete shutdown there.
Ashley is still holding on to Vendetta. I don't know what he's waiting for, what opportunity. He could have gotten two Vendettas off. Waz is about to get his second, so Ashley is playing it very patiently, and it may not pay off. If having found no opportunity to strike, Raikou was a vulnerable target for some time now, and Choccy Milkman are starting to get sloppy here in game number one as Method Black begin to restabilize. They still have that edge. It's likely that Ashley will have to be the target for Method Black, and that's where we have to decide who's more vulnerable, the Mage or the Rogue. Waz is trying to set up some pressure on Gelu. Raikou blinks in. Big Greater Pyro Blast. Tons of damage. Fnobbers denies the kill with Iron Bark. Now Gelu trying to get aggressive here, securing Polymorph on Chaz's Trinket. Waz the target, it looks like, for Ashley, but I do imagine they want to get on back on Raikou as soon as possible. If they don't kill him in another minute and 44 seconds, he will have Ice Block to sustain himself, and that lead that they established early on will be completely lost. Waz is protecting Raikou like a straight god at this point. Every time Raikou's in trouble, Waz is there to back him up, and because of that, Ashley just can't find an opening.
No, he cannot, and Raikou does have the Ice Block coming up in about a minute and a half. That's going to be a huge safety net for Method Black. Still, Choccy Milkman are going to be ahead until that cooldown does reset. They are playing a little bit defensive because of it, realizing Raikou could be in some trouble. Gelu actually offensively ice blocking. They want to close out the game right here, right now. That might have been a huge mistake from Gelu, activating the temporal shield to avoid some of this damage, but just instantaneously, almost for no reason. I feel like there wasn't that much of a moment for them to actually end the game. He just trades out his ice block, still in a lot of trouble. Cycloned low. Waz looking for a re-stealth here. If they get CC on Fnobbers, Gelu could just go down.
It may have just been that they were tired of Ashley being tunneled down and not able to get anything done, but unfortunately that powerful defensive cooldown is no longer available, and Fnobbers is still crowd controlled. Gelu on the run. How is he going to make it out of this alive? He's not able to secure crowd control. He's still in a dangerous situation. Smoke bomb gets dropped. Waz looks to close. That cauterize is not going to be enough, and Gelu throws game number one. Method Black in the lead.
And that ice block looks like utter nonsense coming out from the Milkman here. And that's going to allow Method Black to have a quick victory. Zigo, this isn't something that we expect to see happen, though, again, if we keep moving forward in the series with these compositions, is it?
No, I don't think so. This looks like a good game for the Choccy Milkman in the start. But then Waz just, I don't know, he kept shutting down every single attempt onto Raikou. Raikou didn't have Ice Block or Cauterize for the longest time. And then, of course, Gelu throwing big time with that Ice Block. He Ice Blocked to try to lock out Chaz, but there was just not enough damage to actually do something with that. He wanted to take down Raikou before he was going to have that Ice Block and Cauterize back up off cooldown. But instead, he ended up putting himself in a situation where he was vulnerable. And of course, Waz, Method Black, they're going to pounce on that. And I got to give it out to Chaz as well there. Chaz, that Cyclone on Gelu that allowed Waz to get away and re-stealth and set up again, and also just froze Gelu's HP on about 10%. That was really the big play there towards the end to capitalize on that mistake.
You know, Waz had like a 3-hour period to sit on the bench, just watch, get ready for this series. Do you think that that actually comes into play, though? Do you think that he has been able to maybe watch VOD, think about what he wants to do in a series like this?
Well, I do think playing a multi-hour series, you know, for us, we're kind of just waiting until dampening, but these guys, they have to be paying attention every second of the game, because it could go wrong, you know, if they do fall behind because of big burst damage, or they get interrupted at the bad time. They can ultimately lose. So it is mentally exhausting playing at the very highest level for hours on end. It has been a long day for these players. So I think being Waz, being able to sit back and kind of watch the games and enjoy, you come in fresh, and that is what you want on sort of your all-star player.
Yeah, and now when we look at the Choccy Milkman on the other end, this is a team that has found those mistakes still early in the game quite a bit. We've seen a lot of fast games out of them. Now we're going to see an early mistake coming out of them. The question is, in the future, what do we see from the Choccy Milkman? Do they go for Emir? We're going to see Raikou on fire again. Method Black already locked in on Ashmane's Fall. So nice and balanced map here. Supatiz, do you think Choccy Milkman really have anything else?
I don't think we are going to see anything else. They haven't really utilized anything else throughout the entire tournament. Maybe they've got a curveball, but I highly doubt it. And yeah, Fnabber is going to be coming in again with the same composition, and it may just be the case that we see these two compositions throughout the entire grand final, unless maybe Method Black is down 3 points at some point, and maybe they pull some wild card out. I don't think Choccy Milkman will be making a change, though.
I think that is very important. When we look at the Choccy Milkman right now, Zico, they do seem to be one of those teams that falls into the vein of just being completely skill capped on one composition and not straying too far away from it.
Yeah, that's the beautiful thing about the Choccy Milkman. They just seem to be playing this RMD only, but they play it very, very effectively, beating out a lot of these compositions that some of the other Rogue Mage teams, frankly, have been struggling against. And I also want to say that the map pick is kind of smart as well, because it is a little bit of a takeaway. They could force Method to pick something like the Mage Ellie then on the blind, instead of having that as a counter pick on a big map. They're going to just select the big map right away and try to force it for an RMD mirror, so I like that.
Yeah, I think that we may see them try to go for that quite a bit, and maps are just a little bit more important when we're in the grand final because of how things are going to work in a best of seven. It just gets down to the wire. Eventually, you get to that final game, and the maps that you would typically want to go to, well, they've already been used.
Yeah, exactly. You run out of maps very quickly, but I think picking away maps potentially from Method Black is going to be intelligent for Choccy Milkman, because it's likely going to be a mirror until Method Black loses, if they lose enough. And then at that point, maybe Choccy Milkman does get an advantage because there's no large maps left.
Well, we could see from the vote that you guys had that a lot of you are coming around to the Choccy Milkman. Very impressed by them in this tournament. But the results do not lie from Method Black. They have done it time and time again. They have struck first blood. Will they keep the momentum in their favor?
All right, both mages are going to charge to center field. They don't want their respective druids getting sapped, as that was a bit of a scary start. So instead, they're just going to go toe-to-toe. Greater Pyroblast to Great. Raikou gets his and Gelu doesn't. That's pretty easy. He's getting a second Greater Pyroblast off onto Gelo. Temporal Shield soaks it up and will heal it back. Well-timed by him, but now Cycloned on it. Well done by Chaz. Blind gets Fnabber's Trinket. That's an opening. But Waz actually went all in and Ashley denied him. So Waz has committed a lot of aggressive cooldowns and Ashley is playing it patient. And if Ashley can find that point to hit with this patience, it could just net a kill quite quickly. But in that first game, he wasn't able to find any opportunities. Waz just shut him out left and right. So let's see if they can navigate through Waz's defense to find a kill. Having saved those, they set a swap to Fnabber's, trying to get a bit of a surprise attack. And Fnabber's is not getting caught off guard just yet, but it could be difficult for him to survive if they can stay on target. Another Maledict soaking up all this healing. Chaz jumping on top of Fnabber's. Bit of a peculiar move. Maybe to try and cyclone him at low health. Ashley denies that. Fnabber's on the run. Waz just in pursuit to kill Fnabber's. Maybe this works for him. Let's see if they can keep it going. Not enough damage. Fnabber's is starting to recover, although they're still trying to kill him. I don't think they're going to stay on for much longer. Gelu Baba, Greater Pyroblast gets polymorphed. Raikou goes for his. Raikou gets one Greater Pyroblast. It's going to chunk down Ashley. No follow-up. Easy heal for Fnabber's.
Both mages just channeling Greater Pyroblast. Gelu actually cancels his there because of the Cyclone on Waz. Ashley eats another one. There's a Kidney Shot. Fnabber's getting bashed up. Ashley could be in a lot of trouble playing aggressive. Fnabber's pushed in. He got cross-crowd-controlled by Chaz. And now Ashley on the run. Feint, evasion, everything. No trinket available. Lockout on Chaz. Nicely done by Gelu to slow down some of that crowd control. Ultimately, Ashley will survive that setup. But now, Choccy Milkman, they are very vulnerable. Fnabber's with no trinket. Ashley with no trinket. One nice setup. You can see Waz has the Vendetta coming up in 20 seconds. They can definitely take him down.
Let's see if they can accomplish it here. 13 more seconds, 12 more seconds. Raikou in trouble, but he's got control of the situation even though his health is low. Multiple members are crowd controlled and unable to attack, and it's Ashley that's really the one in danger, I think. Now getting cycloned. Any crowd control on Fnobbers could be the end of the match for the team of Choccy Milkmen as Method Black look to move up to 0 in this grand final, the first grand final of 2019. Who will be the champion? Who's going to earn that king's share of the points to qualify to the spring final LAN later this year? Method Black seem to be in the driver's seat. Gelu trying to be the X factor here at this moment with greater pyro blast, but Waz immediately shuts that out, and Waz has been a great goalkeeper for his team. Ashley in trouble. Crowd control looks good. Vendetta available, but not committed. Instead, Fnobbers overextends his defensive lineup in a bit of a panic attack to save Ashley. That leaves Ashley even more wide open moving forward. He is trying to make something happen on Raikou. He's held onto this Vendetta basically the entire past two games in a row. Finally commits a Vendetta to Raikou, and Raikou simply is just walking away from it. Ashley finally connecting. They need to get a cauterized ice block.
This is it. This is it. All the cooldowns on Ashley with the full blind on Fnobbers. Method Black set it up perfectly. I don't know how Ashley's going to be able to live this one. They just need a little bit more crowd control on Fnobbers. Ashley running for his life and gets taken down. Beautifully done. Waz Raikou saved their offensives. There's the blind on Fnobbers. No trinket. Easy game.
Method Black are definitely back, and I think it's important to talk about quite a few things here when you look at the entirety of the year. If you look at a team, it's actually funny because Kelly Baba found himself in a similar position last year when he was on Reform. If you look at a team like Choccy Milkmen, these early tournaments are absolutely crucial to them. They seem to be focusing on one composition. If they win here, get the king's share of the points, well, it looks like they're going to be able to go to the LAN, and then they just have to play out of their minds at the LAN, and they get that berth straight to the finals for the year. Somebody like Method Black, they just kind of sit back. They let consistency carry them, but already a better performance than they had at the start of their year, and they are looking crazy here, Zico.
Yeah, and it all comes down to these rogue setups that we see from Method Black. Nicely done getting Fnobbers trinket before that blind is even used. You can also see Ashley does not have his cloak, doesn't have his evasion, and Raikou, of course, getting that follow-up CC on that blind is very, very crucial. And another interesting thing in this series is that the best target in this mirror is the rogue. You want to be setting up sheeps on the mage and then bash into ring, something like that on the druid, and kidney shots on that rogue. If one team goes on that rogue and the other team goes on the mage, you're going to see that mage more likely than not survive. Like we saw in game number one, Raikou had to burn through his defensives, and then he still managed to survive with great peels from Waz, being that goalkeeper, like we said. Now, Gelu was actually opting for a little bit more defensive talents, playing Temporal Shield, Greater Pyroblast, as well as the Kleptomania. Temporal Shield being the key factor here. Raikou, on the flip side, is playing the same talents, but instead of Temporal Shield, playing that Flame Cannon, giving him extra damage and extra range as well on his Greater Pyro. Going to make it easier to get those off, and also going to make his Pyroblast and his other damage a little bit more beefy. So it's interesting to see that Gelu played a little bit more defensive after he went down in game number one.
Now, you talk about targeting, and we're going to get into that more, but all of a sudden, you look at this mirror matchup, and for the first time, the Choccy Milkmen are going to be tested, and it is by Method Black. Is Method Black going to be able to snowball this series and take the first grand final of the year? It took Method Black 3 hours to crack the code against their last competition, but now it seems like they've figured out how to just cruise through a best of seven unscathed. Two in their back pocket. They need two more to close the book on this first cup and take the first grand final of the year. My name is Rich. I'm going to be your host. I'm joined by Zico, Supatiz, and Venruki. And it all comes down to potentially a mirror. We talk about a little bit of honor that's on the line with these mirror matchups. It's got to feel very good for them to finally break out that rogue mage and to look so strong.
Yeah, I'm wondering what happened, because right now Method Black looks like they are on fire, but they lost to this team earlier on in the tournament, 0-3, I believe. So I wonder what happened. Maybe they're running different compositions. Maybe they've just smartened up in the mirror, because Right now, I feel like Method Black, they are playing phenomenally.
They are playing out of their minds. They are going to try to get themselves on match point. If you're sitting there at home saying, oh, they already have two, why are they not on match point right now? When we do get to the grand finals today, we're going to have two of them, one for NA and this one right here. They are best of sevens. Choccy Milkmen, they haven't been tested much. They already beat Method Black. This is a rematch. They have not lost a series in this tournament, but that might change in the grand final.
Psychologically, I'm not sure how much experience Ashley has in tournaments on the team. Likely the most inexperienced player, and it seems like he's playing very patiently with his cooldowns and then sometimes just never committing them. Maybe he doesn't want to make a mistake, and ultimately that is putting him behind in such a high momentum matchup. Ashley needs to be the person to lead the charge for the team. Opening up on Chaz for a very aggressive stance, but Waz looks to punish immediately on his back.
Raider.
And now there's a ton of damage. Gets cycloned right at about the last second there. Unfortunate a bit there for Raikou. We would like to see a giant greater pyro connect, but will not. Fanabers is still crowd controlled. Opts to use his Glyre's Medallion, and Waz is just there every single time. Ashley, finally given an opportunity, is going to pull the trigger to attack Waz. Gelu supports with tons of damage, and Waz needs to be a bit careful here. More greater pyro cyclone at low health, and finally, Choccy Milkmen gets some aggression out there.
Yeah, they got bash on Chaz. Chaz had a good answer, though. He got the Iron Bark onto Waz, who didn't have to commit his Cloak of Shadows. In the meantime, Ashley, no Cloak of Shadows, so very vulnerable on that rogue, especially Fnobbers with no trinket available. There's the bash. If Waz can get there for a kidney shot, it's going to be scary, but Ashley goes first. There's a kidney shot on Waz. He's in a little bit of trouble right now. Needs to be able to get away. The Gladiator Safeguard does proc that defensive trinket's going to give him a shield, but now Waz won't have that available for another 2 minutes.
Yeah, finally Ashley finding some pressure points here towards Waz and trying to put a point on this grand final board, a best of seven. Method Black two up in this lead, looking for a first place finish as they were the dominant point earners last year. They want to keep that title to their name in 2019. They are looking unstoppable.
Whoa, huge
swap to Fnobbers as Waz leads the charge. Raikou goes all in. Fnobbers under a lot of pressure. Opts to use most of his defense. It may not be enough. Waz all over him. Ashley gets Frost Nova'd away. He can't support Fnobbers. Waz gets bashed. Fnobbers is not going to choke under the pressure, making his return here for the first time in quite some time and looking to try and do the best for his team. Recovers through a stressful moment. Chaz looking for some clones. Lands one on Ashley. Fnobbers is saying, all right, you're going to take that pillar. I'm going to try and go to another one. But Waz intercepts. Raikou's there to back up with damage. If they can stay on target, Fnobbers does not have much to survive. Ashley tries to save him, peeling both Raikou and Waz away. Really good support here by both Gelo and Ashley to keep Fnobbers afloat. But the Choccy Milkmen have lost all semblance of aggression. They're going to need to try and take advantage of an opening here to kill Waz moving forward. If not, they're just falling more and more behind.
Waz gets the kidney shot on Ashley, followed up with the blind on Fnobbers. Fnobbers has the trinket. That's a Cloak of Shadows overlap with the Iron Bark, with the trinket. Waz taking some damage in the meantime as well. Chaz trying to connect some heals. Doesn't have the Iron Bark, so Waz is going to stay low for just a little bit, especially if Gelu can get any of these greater power blasts off. But it looks like Method Black, they're looking for the game-winning setup once again on Ashley. Ashley running for his life. Full Ring of Frost on Fnobbers. Chaz moving into position, looking to follow up that CC, but Gelo with the good defense, with the Polymorph, with the Dragon's Breath, ultimately keeps Ashley alive.
Oh, Raikou blinks through Gelo, interrupting the Greater Pyroblast that would have dealt huge damage. Another one being casted. Both mages is Greater Pyroblasting each other. Going to be taking some pretty big chunks, but Gelo's getting multiple. Raikou on the back foot, but Waz intercepts right at the end of that chain, and this is trouble. Gelo doesn't have an ice block. Fnobbers can't heal. Ashley is forced to use blind defensively, but that may not even be enough. If Chaz can keep the chain going, he manages to for a couple of extra seconds. He might just be able to do it as Gelo dips low. Cauterize likely to trigger shortly, but they just don't have enough damage. They drop the bomb. Chaz is carrying with that Star Surge as well, adding to the damage. They managed to get the Cauterize because of Chaz's extra added damage and the Cyclone on the Temp Shield, but may not be timed. He's looking for the next one to time it on the Temp Shield. He nails it. Chaz is carrying right now. Method Black want this Greater Pyro Star Surge combo. Fnobbers barely keeping him in the fight.
When did Gelo use his ice block? I feel like he uses it offensively or maybe defensively to try to keep Fnobbers alive, and that is a good job by Method Black, making sure they're pressured, making sure Gelo feels like he has to trade out that ice block defensively and not for himself. Now Waz taking a little bit of damage with the meteor landing on him. That is going to proc his Gladiator Safeguard.
Even with that, Waz might just fall here in game three.
What?
Waz has Iron Bark, but Waz is teetering on the edge of defeat, barely hanging on and managing to stay in it. I guess, sort of, kinda. Waz, now, if he survives, this is terrible for Choccy Milkman. He gets cycloned at low health. This is dangerous. Fnobbers is trying to carry. He gets a clone, but it's diminishing returned on Chaz. A mistake here by Fnobbers. Chaz now can freely heal. Waz recovers. 30 seconds on Vendetta for Waz. He gets his before Ashley. Blind on Fnobbers. Opts to break out immediately and save the day. Waz stuns the trinket. Raikou, if he gets a polymorph here, he does. Ashley has to use Cloak of Shadows Innovation. Every cooldown for Choccy Milkman has now been committed on two members. And at this point, if you're Method Black, you can look to close. Ashley needs to end this game right here and now if they want to have a hope of winning this. Gelu gets a couple graders. Waz in a bit of trouble. Barely holding on here. Finally, Choccy Milkman are showing signs of life in this series. They still got it.
Yeah, Chaz actually had a trinket out of a hibernate there, so that's an opening now for Choccy Milkman. If Ashley has blind available, could be scary. Cyclone now on Ashley, slowing down a little bit of damage. Who's going to be the main target? Is it going to be Ashley, or is it going to be Gelu for Method Black?
At this point, Gelu seems to be the target. Raikou leading the charge here. Chaz and Waz actually are retreating away. Ashley puts up, or is pushing forward. Fnobbers moves across as well. Fnobbers out in midfield, just nailing Cyclones right now onto Method Black. Gelu blinks in aggressively. Pretty cheeky considering he doesn't have an ice block. He's going to polymorph Waz, dispelled instantly. Polymorph the dispel. What are you trying to set up right here, Gelu? You're just standing so far forward. Ashley got a restart, but Raikou's getting greater pyros. Gelu doesn't have an ice block. Raikou got a counterspell. Everything is in going perfect order right now for Method Black. Is Fnobbers going to be able to handle the pressure here? We just step foot into dampening. There's not much left for Gelu to make this final stand as Maledict soaks up all of the healing. It's a race against the clock. That temporal shield is ticking. Gelu's buying a couple seconds, and it manages to go off and potentially keep him alive. No Cyclone at low health. Chaz is on fire with his Balance Affinity, just Star Surging and Cyclone. I've really not seen a Druid utilize Balance Affinity as effectively as he is in this match. Definitely skill capped on that Druid. Gelu once again getting greater pyroed by Raikou. Fnobbers caught in Kidney Shot. Raikou needs to chain it together. He's in position. He gets the chain. Everyone in crowd control. 11 more seconds for Gelu. He needs 10 more seconds to get out of this awkward situation. He's trying to buy it. 7 more seconds. Fnobber's Ironbark will buy him time. And in the meantime, Ashley goes for a game-winning play. The game-winning swap for the reverse potentially onto Chaz. They go all in for the kill. Can the Choccy Milkman do it? Raikou pauses the game out. Polymorphing Ashley away. Chaz holds on. Gelu is still low. And at this point, it's still anyone's match.
It definitely is. Gelu is low, though. He did trinket out. Temporal Shield was activated. Greater Power Blast coming in from Raikou. They're trying to set up onto Ashley, who has no trinket, but every single other defensive cooldown might need to get a preemptive Cloak of Shadows or something. Method Black looking for the game-winning crowd control. Bash on Fnobbers. Kidney Shot on Ashley. Do they have the damage to figure it out? Gelu manages to get the double Dragon's Breath on Waz and Raikou. Polymorph on Raikou. Gelu's just doing such a good job with the Dragon's Breath, but that Cyclone coming in from Chaz is going to deny any incoming healing from Fnobbers, trying to get that Iron Bark. Fnobbers has to connect it. Garrote Silence nicely done once again by Waz, continuing the CC chain with the full Kidney Shot. Now Ashley, super vulnerable, activates the evasion, not panicking. He used the Cloak of Shadows. After Cloak of Shadows, then the evasion. Fnobbers still in CC, though, trying to survive. Drops the Smoke Bomb, blind on Fnobbers, and there's no way Ashley can possibly live this. Still just dancing with death, trying to escape. Fnobbers connects the Iron Bark, and I can't believe the miracle they just pulled off.
I said Ashley was likely the least experienced member in the arena, but that move right there to stay alive, which should have been defeat, manages to keep his team going, but the crowd control is endless as Method Black lead another attack. Defensive blind, but on diminishing return, Ashley doesn't have much left to keep this going. Gelu needs to make a move, but he gets Dragon's Breath away. Now Dragon's Breath needs the team, but there's just nothing. The crowd control keeps going, and Chaz's play on Druid, definitely MVP here for Method Black. They move 3-0 in the series. They need one more win to claim it all and be the first champions of the European region in the Arena World Championship Series 2019.
And what a game to get on match point with. I think you look over on the side of the Choccy Milkman, and at any given moment, they have no cooldowns available. Like, there's just so much pressure coming out, but they still find ways to stay alive, to keep themselves in it. Zico, you got to give it up for the Choccy Milkman, but it did seem like the ball was just completely in Method's court.
I wouldn't even say it was completely completely Method's core. I would say Method Black, they for sure had more pressure points to work with. We saw opportunities to kill Snowburst. We saw opportunities to kill Gelu, very, very close to killing him. We saw eventually Ashley fall in the end. So they were pressuring multiple points in the game. But at the same time, I wouldn't say it was completely one-sided. We saw the Choccy Milkman almost taking down Waz at one point. I couldn't believe that Waz survived that one setup earlier on, even before dampening. He survived on, like, what, 5% or so? Yeah. Unbelievable, actually. Both of these teams played phenomenal in this game. I really like this one.
Yeah, I think that's where you really commend the Choccy Milkman, though, because there was so much pressure on him, and they find goals out of miracles, right? Like, all of a sudden, Ashley just looks like he's going to be taken out, and I think it's Sid who just says the experience that Ashley shows to be able to stay alive there with nothing to actually support a rogue, it was very crazy to watch.
I mean, how many people can go toe-to-toe with Method Black and how many years they've been playing together on Rogue Mage, really, if you think about it, and Choccy Milkman is kind of a newly formed roster, and they're still putting up quite a fight. They could possibly reverse sweep this. They'd have to win four in a row, but I definitely think they would be the team capable of doing it. Obviously, Method Black have had a fire lit underneath themselves here in this tournament, being knocked down by this team in the first place, looking to not have that repeat itself. And it's quite obvious with all three members playing to the absolute maximum here in this grand final.
Obviously, at this point, you're going to favor Method Black just due to the overwhelming amount of games that they've already taken down. But you look at the Choccy Milkman, you do know that they are a team capable of getting the reverse sweep. That is definitely something that you need to take into effect. But Chaz, man, Chaz looked so good in that last game. What was he doing right? Let's start there.
Well, what's really important on that Druid is pushing in for the right timing. So you want to get those Bash Cyclones, the Bash to set up your Mage for the Ring of Frost, and also the offensive Cyclone to pause people's HP, freeze them. So if you get an Iron Bark on Ashley, for example, and he's 40% HP, you don't want to allow the enemy Druid, Fnobbers, any sort of additional healing with that, so you Cyclone and blow, and then you deny that Iron Bark potential.
Yeah, so you see that cooldown get traded out, throw him into Purgatory essentially by getting him into that Cyclone, wait for that to fall off, and then you can get that pressure going on the target that you've already whittled down, gotten into the danger zone.
Well, it just becomes an extended CC chain, so if you get 18 seconds of CC on Fnobbers with Kidney Shot and Ring of Frost and Cyclone, 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 and then all of a sudden you're Cycloning Ashley as well, that's all of a sudden 20 seconds or more that Fnobbers hasn't been able to heal, and then you're also just waiting for diminishing returns to come back up. All of a sudden, after the triple Cyclone on Ashley, Fnobbers is back off stun DR, and they can extend the chain and continue it.
Yeah, you wait for that DR to tick off on your main target, and then you get a full-powered Cyclone on the potential kill target. So what do we expect to see change, if anything, headed into this next game, Zico?
I think both teams are going to keep playing the same compositions, and it's going to come down to who plays better. Like, I would say right now, I think Waz is a little bit of the X factor. He's shutting down so many of these greater pyros. He's doing a phenomenal job setting up kills onto Ashley as well. I would say Gelu and Fnobbers, they're kind of on par with Raikou and Chaz in terms of landing crowd control on those druids. But it also comes down to Method Black just having a little bit better target selection in general as a team, because they don't overextend to kill Ashley, even though they force everything from Ashley. Instead, they find an opportunity to start forcing out the cooldowns from Gelu, maybe do a swap to Fnobbers, and I think that's what they gotta keep doing. They gotta keep the enemy team guessing and just keep applying pressure to whoever will take that damage.
Yeah, we really need to break that down, because it's something that we always talk about in the mirror matchup, is going to be the targeting. Are you trying to find a kill on the mage, which we see a lot of the time, trying to whittle down that ice block. If they are Frost, get rid of the Cold Snap. If they are going to be Fire, you get rid of the Carterize as well. But sometimes a Rogue Race is something that happens, and when we look at both of these Rogues, they're getting their cooldown stripped away from them time and time again. So what does dictate who you are going to be targeting and when?
Well, mostly it's positioning. If the rogue is positioning himself super far away, and you as a mage, for example, you're slowed up by his crippling poison, and you don't want to blink behind that pillar and expose yourself, and Gelu is, of course, going to be in the middle in that situation to kind of try to weather that storm, then it's a good opportunity to swap to Gelu maybe. Or also, if you've gotten successful setups onto the rogue and Gelu has used his ice block to shut down one of those crowd control chains like we saw in the previous match, then you can have that in your back pocket that, okay, if Ashley gets away too much, then we can still switch over to Gelu. And then also the diminishing return, if Ashley just isn't able to be stunned because he's already been stunned, then you can maybe use your stun on somebody who still is off that DR and force the pressure that way.
Yeah, so we are going to see as well Choccy Milkman here picking a very congested map, a very small map in Hook Point. Sid, what does this broadcast to you?
Well, I thought they would be a little bit stressed out here. They're one loss away from going home, and they pick the most difficult map to really get away if things go wrong. So maybe they just go all out. Who knows? They might just try and run down Method Black. We saw towards the end they were going after Chaz quite frequently. That is definitely an option with the way that he's playing and the talent build that he is currently running. And on a small map like this where he can't so easily escape, it could be an option for them. And I'm curious to see if they employ it.
I'm not sure if people still say this, but this is a little bit YOLO, right, Fenriki?
Yes, it could be a little bit YOLO, but we saw Choccy Milkman earlier on in the tournament play really aggressive. And honestly, I feel like with the way Method Black's been playing it, they've been forcing Choccy Milkman to play way too defensive. They're using their blinds on Waz in order to survive. Gelu's been having to use his Quaking Palm racial just to live. So I feel like Choccy Milkman on this map, they need to play their game, which is the very aggressive gameplay. They just need to kind of outplay Method at this point.
Yeah, outplay them in an aggressive style isn't something that's going to be easy to pull off, but Hook Point should help with that, right, Zico?
Well, Hook Point just makes it easier to actually chase down those targets. I think Hook Point also opens up opportunities to kill those druids a little bit easier as well. We saw a lot of time the Choccy Milkman would try to kill Chaz because he's just in their face with that Moonkin Affinity, spamming out those clones, being very, very annoying. And then Chaz would just get around those pillars, and then all of a sudden, you're not going to be able to catch him anymore. However, on a small map like Hook Point, even if Chaz does get away, it's much easier to reconnect back onto Chaz and continue that pressure.
You have to point out, though, Choccy Milkman, pretty much every series that we have seen from them has been fast. They definitely are pacemakers. You can see that even though they are going down here, they still try to dictate that tempo, try to keep it quicker. That is where they are the most comfortable. But Method Black, no strangers to any tempo. They have danced this dance many and many a time, and they are looking to grab one more win here and grab their first grand final win of the year. If you look back to last year, they pretty much owned all of the grand finals, and they are on a tear yet again. Hook Point may decide the first cup for EU.
Yeah, definitely could. Choccy Milkman one game away from being eliminated from this tournament. Method Black, they want to close this out. A clean 4-0 sweep in this tournament. Raikou looking for some early greater pyroblasts onto Gelu, manages to find one. Kidney shot on Fnobbers. Waz and Raikou getting aggressive on Fnobbers right away. Raikou pulls the trigger on his combustion, but with Ashley himself, he's able to shut that down quite easily with the Garrote Silence. Cheap shot on Waz. Now a counter go on Chaz, who could be in some trouble.
Yeah, at this point, they are getting aggressive on both sides by gunning down the Restoration Druids on such a close-quartered map as Hook Point. This is an option for them. They do pull Trinket from Fnobbers now with a blind. Method Black with a lead in that regard. We have not seen Ashley commit that cooldown just yet, and that's really been the name of the game, is that Waz goes for the plays. He knows them, and he makes them, and he does them every single time consistently, whereas Ashley is a bit more inconsistent as they do set up another attempt to kill Chaz. And that may just be the case that they YOLO down, as Rich would like to say.
Whoa.
Chaz in trouble. Fnobbers get swapped too, and they may reverse the pressure. It could be a cross kill, as both druids are dangerously low on health. Maledict's connect towards Fnobbers. He's on match points. He doesn't have much to work with. Good support from the team, but once again, a defensive blind on Waz means they cannot use that aggressively, and that tells me that Method Black have momentum, have the lead.
Once again, Gelu uses his ice block very offensively there, defensively, to keep Fnobbers alive, but now he doesn't have that for another 4 minutes. It's going to be a very vulnerable target for their team. All they need is one good setup. Ashley with no trinket. This kidney shot could be scary. Greater Power Blast being used by Raikou. Gelu tries to shut it down with the Blink Dragon's Breath. Manages to find it. Waz looking for a reset right now. I think if Method Black can get one more clean CC chain, they can take Gelu down quite easily here.
All right, Gelu, what are you going to do? You're on match points. You don't got much to stay alive. And they're just going to gun down Waz behind the corner. Chaz moves over, but Fnobbers jumps in to continue a chain. Raikou needs to block, and he does. Nice job by Raikou, intercepting and now reversing it. Ashley and Gelu both in trouble, and it looks like Gelu's going to be the target. Waz wants to secure this win. He wants this clean sweep 4-0, the janitor treatment towards Choccy Milk, but Gelu defends. well-placed temporal shield soaking it, but gets cycloned on it by Chaz. Chaz just playing out of his mind in this series throughout the entire day. He played a three-hour series to get here, and he's still just playing out of his mind. They've got a massive lead. If you get any crowd control in Fnobbers, they don't have it. And now Gelubaba should likely recover. Greater Pyroblast race. Raikou gets another. Gelu's in trouble. Fnobbers isn't responding. It's going to connect. Gelu dip flow. Chaz jumps in, trying to get the crowd control. Fnobbers able to avoid it, but no, the Cyclone is secured. If he trinkets this, he's going to get blinded later. He can't. Gelu has to survive on his own. Cauterize triggers. He's on the run, but it might just not be enough here as Gelu barely stays alive. But that's all they've been able to do is just stay alive. They can't get anything going. Another Cyclone on the temporal shield. Chaz is just easily asserting that druid dominance here today against the Choccy Milkmen. Gelu in trouble. Fnobbers locked down in the silence anymore. There's
all
the blind.
Blind.
No trinket. No way. Gelu hangs on. Shield absorb. Tanking out. He's got less HP than I've ever seen and somehow stays in it. Choccy Milkmen stay alive, but like I said, that's all they've been able to do.
Raikou once again looking for the greater power blast. Did he get it off? Gelu's still just running for his life. Ashley had used the smoke bomb defensive once again. Raikou once again looking for another greater power blast. Fnobber still in the polymorph. Gelu getting low. Doesn't have the blazing barrier available just yet. And that is the only thing that kept him alive. And that last go temporal shield also paying dividends. Keep him alive. Finally, Gelu's HP stabilizes. Chaz still has his trinket, though. He still has the Iron Bark. Method Black, their CC chain isn't over. There's a full kidney shot. Bash Cyclone onto Fnobbers. Gelu all by himself once again, but Fnobbers did a great job there. He got the preemptive Iron Bark to prevent a lot of that damage, and that's what kept Gelu up.
Oh, man. Gelu should be counting his stars at this point to be alive. Let's see if the Choccy Milkmen can pull it off. They've just been playing against the wall. Method Black up in their face, start to finish this entire series, trying to close this out. And somehow Choccy Milkmen stay on the edge of their seat. There's the smoke bomb. Fnobbers are trying to get inside, but does he have enough time? One Swift Man, but he walks into a clone. Ashley all alone goes for a vanish, tries to save the day, but Waz is just all over him, and he's going to go down. Method Black. 4-0, they are back.
And they get to do it in a mirror as well, which is going to be a great way for them to start off the year when it doesn't even look like this looks so similar to last year. They have Rogue Mage, it's great right now, and they don't even need it because they have Swapsy, who's one of the best players in the world. They are a threat. It doesn't matter what year it is. It could be the year 20 to 28, and they would still be one of the scariest forces that we've ever seen. But I have to say, it is so much fun to watch the Choccy Milkmen play. They just want to go fast, and that is it. And they also are so damn good. I mean, let's just look at Gelu. This guy will first global an ice block and then just be immune to Death's Eco.
Absolutely crazy stuff coming out of these guys. Honestly, both teams played phenomenal. I really think that this series could have gone a lot more in the favor of Choccy Milkmen. They had so many close attempts on killing Waz, on killing Chaz, and you know, it just came down to Method Black. Today they were the better team, they were the hungrier team, and also this is the reason why they are the only team out of everybody who made it to BlizzCon last year to actually stick together. They know what they have is working. They have the perfect mix of the Rogue Mage and those offensive compositions. They have a healer who can play pretty much everything on that top tier level, and they also have Swapsy who can just bring in that other perspective from the dampening point of view and just round out this roster perfectly.
Yeah, and I think that the Choccy Milkmen, though, have definitely made some new fans today, getting to watch them. I know right now I have enjoyed getting to watch what they do quite a bit, and as much as this is a 4-0, this is one of those times where numbers are going to lie to you. Math can sometimes be tricky like that and cruel like that. When we actually look at what we've seen from them so far, they were able to take down this team previously in the tournament. And if you saw that series, you're probably not all that surprised. They look fantastic in the games. They had a lot of opportunities. But Method Black today is going to just look fantastic. And they are the best team in Europe. A grueling run, too, Elliot, from the lower portion of the bracket.
Yeah, they had to get through a lot of really good teams. Enlight earlier on in the tournament, and then Minpoike's team, which was a difficult matchup. They managed to 3-0 them as well. And then, of course, Baba's Boys, the almost 3-hour-long series that they had to battle their way through in the lower lower final.
Well, they start off with Tempo Storm, though, too. So they take off Tempo
Storm.
Yeah,
sure. I didn't even see that one.
Yeah, they start off with Tempo Storm. They take them out, and then it goes, hey, Zuni, how have you been, man? It's been a while since we've gotten to play together. Bye. Then they go over, hey, man, Poike, how you doing? Easy, Poike. Take him down. Then they get on over to Baba's boys, and that one takes a very long time. And then it's a quick 4-0 coming out against the Choccy Milkman. And you look at the Choccy Milkman, Sid.
They knocked him down in the first place.
Exactly, and they got to hang out the entire time. That is the only series that they did lose in this tournament, being the team coming in from the upper side.
It was a pretty insane day for Method Black, but I'm sure that they're ecstatic being able to take a first place finish and still kind of maintain the lead for now in terms of the top point earners across the globe. I'm wondering if that's kind of an achievement for them. They just got it running. Like, we always have to be the top point earners, and that's all we really care about, but for now, they will remain as the top point earners.
Yeah, and their day now over. They're going to take home the crown, but ours is not. We are going to get to flip over the record, go to side B. It's time for NA. We have a full tournament now there. It's going to be those top four teams, and we are going to start whittling them down. We're going to start off with that elimination series too, I believe. And I just can't wait to see what North America has in store. We've seen somewhat similar things in the meta, though, so far, Zico, but we still have some Paladins hanging out.
Yeah, well, we have one Paladin hanging out, Rub Cub.
They're
going to be the final hope of, well, not just the Paladins, but actually any other healer other than Druid in this tournament. In both regions, there's both top fours have, well, seven Druid teams and then one Paladin team being Rub Cub's team. We're going to see them playing that Fire Mage Assassination Holy Paladin very soon. And we also have a lot of Warlock Resto Druid compositions there. We got Maldiva hanging out in North America as well, looking forward to see his games. We have Snuts as well, going to be playing in Super Frogs, and we saw them playing similar stuff to Method Black with that Rogue Mage Druid. We know they have a lot of options, a lot of exciting games coming.
Now, a lot of powerful teams mentioned there, and you might be saying, what are they playing for? Well, it is to get to the first LAN of the year and to try to ultimately get to the finals of the year. And we can see the European teams already starting that journey. Now, Method Black, once again, this is where they like to hang out on our standings graphic. Number one, 120 points behind them, the Choccy Milkman with 100. Typically, when you do see somebody grab that first place, you're relatively confident they are going to make it to the LAN. But Method Black, they never take their foot off the pedal, not at all. But if you're looking at some of these teams and you're saying, oh, some of these teams with 20 points, I can take them down. Wouldn't it be too much of a problem? Well, prove it. You can sign up right now. The signups for EU for cup number two are going to be ending in just 1 hour, so you need to do it, and you need to do it quickly. We would love to cast over some new faces. We've already been doing it, and they have not disappointed, not at all. A lot of these new teams showed that they can really go toe-to-toe with some of the greats, but it's time for North America now. Sign up for EU. We can see you guys next week, but North America going to be our focus. A new champion is the old champion of the EU. It's Method Black yet again putting on a show, but congratulations to all of the teams that made it so far. Now it's time for a fulcrum shift. It's time for North America